Get out of my way! Move it, people! I have roads to carve! Yeah!
Good afternoon, YouTube. Today, I want to tell you all about Drive On Demand's Porsche 911 Carrera 4S. This is the 997, so it's a 2007, and it's absolutely awesome. I know a lot of you have been waiting to see this one get reviewed in particular. Let's take it out for a drive, and I'll tell you all about how badass this thing is. Alright, we're in the Porsche 911 Carrera 4S. Now, one thing to remember is with these Porsches, the key actually goes in on the left-hand side. And, oh yeah. It's a fairly stiff clutch. It's not ridiculous, but it's got some stiffness to it. This one does have an aftermarket Pioneer stereo, so you have at least Bluetooth and you know, talk on your phone and drive and whatever. It does have also a fairly simple and easy to deal with climate control system. So, I mean, it's a fairly basic car. Controls are just pretty basic. So it's a fairly simple driver's car. That's really what this thing is. The stick on this is a little interesting. It's like springy. It goes back to neutral, like, it's like, beow, goes right back to neutral. So, well, I need to wash the windshield. All right, let's see if I can figure this out. Nope. I don't know how to make the windshield wipers do the spray. All right, well, whatever, let's drive. All right, so the steering already is very heavy, and actually it's a very big steering wheel. I'm kind of surprised at the size of the steering wheel. So the bite on the clutch is right at the bottom, the last like eighth of an inch. So it's, you know, you got a lot of travel and then all of a sudden it disengages at the last moment. Not too bad. It's takes a second to get used to. I'm already, you know, getting the hang of that. So being that this is the 4S, that means we actually have all the drive in this car. So the gauges are laid out really nice. You have the tach right in the center. Speed to the left, temperature to the right. Interesting enough, the fuel is to the right of the temperature, and then you have oil pressure, which this thing's holding 4 bar right now, which is really good oil pressure. We actually do have rear seats, believe it or not, and we have a nice Alcantara ceiling with, or roof with, it actually has a moonroof that can open. It's actually kind of a nice day. Yeah. Some light in here. It's just a roof, there's no window or anything like that. So, all right, here we go, let's get going. Transmission, the shifting is really smooth, very short. It's not as short as like the Corvette, believe it or not, but it's very direct, really simple, it goes into place very nicely. I actually joked in the video about the Corvette how the Corvette feels like you gotta punch it into gear and beat it. You go into gear, it chunks in the gear, you know, it really, like, it almost takes, like, it's like America go in gear, America. And this thing, it's like it just goes in really soft and smooth. It just chink 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 right into gear, super light. Don't have to worry about like throwing it in there. It just goes in the gear. Simple car. Steering is very precise. You know, you get a lot of feedback hitting this. You can feel that. You can feel all those little bumps in the steering wheel. You can feel in the pedals. I mean, the car, there's like very little body roll. It's a, I mean, this is a Porsche. This is a 911. This is This is why everyone loves Porsches, because they are just outstanding. Oh, it's so tight. Everything about this car is just really tight, very precise. It's got a nice raw sound to it, so there's no turbo in this car. I don't know the specs, but it's actually not that powerful. It's not super quick, but it's so nimble that it just... Oh, yeah. It's just an excellent, excellent car. Oh, the sound. The naturally aspirated Porsches, the flat six, is just... Oh. They just sound so good. It's got that nice, like, mechanical sound to it. It just... Oh, it's fantastic. You have a 6-speed transmission, so you can actually get fairly decent mileage. Oh, look at that. First time driving, I can heel toe in this car. The pedals are set up perfectly. Porsche knows what they're doing, man. This is a great car. Jack, stop getting a boner. The only downside is it does not have that much low-end torque. I'm wishing it had more. Here we go. Yeah, I wish it had just a little bit more torque and it would be perfect. So I can see why you want the turbo, but the handling, oh, look at this handling. Oh, God, it just skates around the corner. 3,000 RPM, so 30 miles an hour. I'll put it to the floor already. Floored, 4,000, 5,000, 45, 50. And it's quick, it's quick. It's a quick car, but it's, the torque band is definitely in the upper RPMs. You can feel it hit at 4,000 really strong. 3,000, it's just not quite there, but 4,000, 5,000, it really starts to pull, really starts to feel good. But God, this handling, oh, it's just so good. Really, this is excellent handling. Here. Stop talking good about these things. No, stay good to Ferrari, stay true. Enzo will haunt me. All right, here we go again. Let's give it some hell again. Ready? Here we go. Oh, yeah. It's 55. Towing like an expert with no, like, this is my second time driving this car and I'm heel towing what, in 2 minutes perfectly. Brakes are good too. It just, oh man, it's interesting. So the brakes don't bite very hard at first. They kind of come in soft and then they really grab, so it's a little bit soft, and then, holy shit. So got big brakes, it can definitely stop. Believe it or not, this thing actually has rear seats. I'm not gonna Doug DeMiro and try and sit back there, because yeah, they're not designed for humans. They're designed for, I don't know why. They're just there. They don't really do anything. It's a pretty basic computer, you know, it tells me miles per gallon. It actually, believe it or not, this thing has like this ancient navigation system, which you'll never use, so we're just not even gonna talk about it. It does show me tire pressure, which is cool, so it actually has the actual readout on the computer. It's kind of an old school computer. It's very analog digital looking, you know, it's very, you can see the little pixels and stuff. It's not like a modern nice screen and color and everything. It shows basic stuff like miles per gallon, how much fuel you have, how long you have until your fuel's empty, so how many miles it can go, temperature, time, pretty basic car. It's meant to be driven. It's not meant to be, you know, this luxurious comfort cruise across the planet kind of car. It is a sports car. This is definitely a sports car feel to it. Although, admittedly, the seats are comfortable. The bolsters are not huge. You know, I can move around quite a bit. You're not gonna fall out of them, but they're not like the Ferrari where you're in the seat and that's you know, you're not going anywhere. Kind of a combination between comfort and sport on the seats. They're plenty sporty, yet your butt's not gonna be complaining on a road trip. So you could actually do a road trip. Trunk in this thing is fairly small. You're not gonna be putting a bunch of shit in it, unfortunately. And of course, being that it's a 4S, it means it actually has the wide body, so it makes it look really nice. I don't like the look of the Porsches when they don't have the wide body. So the thing about these Porsches, I've driven a few of these, and I've even driven a few 911s on the track. And it's interesting because, you know, they do have the engine in the rear, so you do have a lot of weight in the rear, which does make it a little bit interesting to drive hard. So they're good enough cars that, you know, anyone can get in it and drive it fast without much fanfare and without much trouble. But to drive it near its limits, it takes a little bit more balls, and it takes a little bit of getting used to the fact that you do have to manage the weight and keep the weight shifted to where you need it. So it's got weird stuff like, you know, if you let off in a corner, it actually can be bad because some of the weight will pull off the tires and it'll ease up. Light, it's like airy. It's hard to explain, but just it's so light. It's kind of strange. If you have not driven one of these, you need to. The handling is just so superb. This is so fun to drive. Banging through these gears makes me feel like everything's a racetrack. You just want to be cutting through traffic and cutting corners and flying down a curvy road. You know, get out of my way. Move it, people. I have roads to carve. Yeah. Porsche knows what they're doing. They make superb cars, and this is not any exception of that rule. This is an outstanding, excellent, excellent car. Just fantastic. The only disappointment I have is it does lack low-end torque. It could use some more low-end torque. Of course, the same's gonna be true of the turbos. They're not gonna have a whole lot of low-end torque either. These motors just need to be revved in order to be driven. If you want to have fun, you need to stay in the upper RPM. It's nothing like the Corvette where, you know, the Corvette at idle will pull down a house. Hey, another Porsche 911. Unfortunately with Porsches, they made a lot of these things, so they are everywhere. So you don't get that same special feeling that you do in the Ferrari. Some people care about that, some people don't. I personally do. I think that's important to me. I want to feel emotionally, you know, attached to the car. These things are just solid. They're just a damn good car. All right, Jack, you can stop masturbating. You need to rent Drive on Demand's Porsche 911. It is an absolutely awesome car. It's so much fun, and Porsche just knows what they're doing. They just build really good cars, and there's a reason why everyone loves them. The old 997s are awesome. They have the great look on them. They have the reliability, they have performance, they have handling, they have comfort. It's hard to find anything wrong with the damn thing. Shut up, Jack. If you guys want to rent our Porsche, send me an email, dan@driveondemand.com, and I can hook you up with $25 off, so feel free to send me an email. Otherwise, visit driveondemand.com. Check out all of our cars. We have lots of cars. We have a Maserati, Jaguar F-Type S, the Corvette, 911. We have a Boxster, and we're working on getting a few more cars. Oh, and we also have a BMW M3. So lots to choose from. Awesome cars, all cars that us car enthusiasts love. So you guys should check it out. Again, driveondemand.com. Otherwise, we'll be seeing you soon. We'll be doing lots of car stuff, so stay tuned. It's gonna be sweet.